Hi everyone, it's Timbergiant Bigfoot. I just posted a video there a couple days ago with the wood knocking and tree falling down, and a lot of people saying they think it's a gunshot. Gunshots has happened a couple times. And I can understand how people would think that, because it is such a rather explosive sound. But you gotta take it from me, it's a tree falling. Actually, the reason I've come back out here is I just want to sit in this spot up here and refilm. I think it's the hillside, and see if we can see this what appears to be a red shape that pops up in the video, I guess. That's what people are telling me. I don't personally see it just yet. Maybe I don't know where to look in the video, but I'm not seeing it. You know, when it comes to my videos, I'm probably one of the most critical people out there on my own stuff. So I typically have this opinion that, you know, how can you be seeing something in the video? I was there, I didn't see it. It's that frame of thinking, you know. And so when I'm standing here, looking down here, I don't know how, you know, how I could possibly miss something. It's just down there behind one of these trees. Anyway, here I am standing here at this tree. It's the wood knocking tree. You know, I've thought about this since I've been down here banging on this tree a few times, and I'm pretty sure that this is the tree that I hear quite often when I'm out way out that way looking around. It just has such an echo to it. Anyway, that's what I was doing, wood knocking on the tree, and I believe I sat right here, put the wood knocker down, and I sat down, and it was sunny. That's the only difference, is it was sunny the other day. I sat right here, and I had the monopod down, I believe. And I filmed back and forth down there a bit. And seemed to have caught something down there. I don't know what. Don't know if I really have or not. Yeah, I don't see anything down here that looks like this reddish creature behind some trees. You know, for me, it's that big tree right over there. That's maybe 100 feet. It's kind of hard to see how I would be able to miss something that's relatively close like that. Hillside is still pretty slippery. There's something that's happened over the summer. And these are typically the trees I use as wood knocking trees, except they don't make a very good sound. Hear that? It's a sound seems to come from the wood knocker as opposed to from the tree. Whoa. This doesn't make a very good wood knocking tree. It makes a very crisp sound. It doesn't travel very far. Holy cow, this is slippery. Well, there's a tree I broke off. You know, what I have found to be an interesting experiment is that anybody who thinks they have Sasquatch in their forest can try. It doesn't mean it's going to happen or work. It doesn't even mean that what's happening here is a result of these creatures. But this is the scenario. You know, you find a dead tree like this, nice hollow one. That'd be a good wood knocking tree too. And actually, it's not even dead, so it's not going to work. As I say, try to push it over, it's never going to move. It doesn't have the same sound. And sometimes you'll come back and find this tree that you've already tried to push over, supposedly, will be broken off. Like, lo and behold, something is watching you and said, ha, he can't do it, I'll do that. and comes along and breaks the tree up. In this area, I find a lot of worked up muddy areas. I imagine this is from the deers running up and down the hill. I don't believe it's always the case. There used to be a trail right over there, you can see it. And right up there is the tree that's falling across the trail. Along with the big tree that fell down over there. See it back there? So I mean, all these trees that have mysteriously fallen across the trails, it's rather odd. You'll find trees that are, you know, the ministry people had cut down, dropped them across the trails. But now, it seems that there's a multitude of trees that have been just pushed down across the trails. It's like somebody is playing the one-up game. Now, if I was to show you this and say, here's a tree snap, everybody would agree. Right? Of course you would. Imagine the power it's taken to break this tree. It's still under like some tension there, I'm sure. There's already something else stuck in the tree. Another tree snap. Lots of tree snaps. Busted off everywhere. One of the reasons I don't typically come back in here is because I filmed something back here one time, and I found it kind of frightening when I look at the video and I see this shape up in the tree, and it just bothered me. I was like, I don't know, I don't want to go back here. It was just back here somewhere, not terribly far back. I kind of passed it off as a broken tree, but it's clearly not a broken tree. Another impressive tree snap. And yet another tree snap right there. Pretty new too. Not sure how well it's showing up. See, here's one of these tree snaps. It doesn't appear to be caused by the wind or anything. It's not even a cut. It's not a chainsaw mark or anything. It's just a totally snapped off tree. It snapped off up there. And it's pretty high up. Very cleanly broken. It's almost like it was broken while it was frozen. You know, the forest around here changes so much. You go from this like maple hardwood forest into that. And that's pretty ugly stuff. It's all thorn trees and crab apple trees and vines and you know, I've had some people saying in the past, you know, in the last couple of years, that when you see that video with the big red creature sitting and then crouching in front of this this dead white tree from the another footprint found video, when I'm back up on the hill there filming it unknowingly, the creature actually gets up, disappears back in there. If you watch closely, I think they're right. If I didn't know better, I almost think I heard a wood knock. I'm not sure. Oop. 40 more feet to go and I'm done. Get up to my hilltop. Let's see what's going on up here today. I'm doing it. No hands climb. Where it starts to get to you. Right about here. Let's see. Let's see. Broken tree, maybe? I don't know what that is. It's very small. Way over there. I certainly can't tell what it is on the camera. Anyhow. That wasn't something twisting a tree, I don't know what it was. Where was that? It wasn't far away. It's straight back in there somewhere. Definitely sound like something. I don't see anything. The sound was I don't know how to describe that. It sounded like heavy creak. Sounded like a kind of a slow, deliberate creaking crack sound of wood, you know, twisting or bending or breaking nonetheless. It wasn't from back there, it was from back there.
Well, the day I was out here recording the falling tree sounds, just the last time I was out, I also recorded this area, and these stones and stuff that are here, I think they're just the way I left them. Here they are. And this looks like a walking stick stuck in the tree. This is just the way that I left it, which is just the way I found it. You know, I have found so many what turn out to be walking sticks. You know, I've kept them and all that. You know, it seems like something leaves them in these very peculiar positions for me to find, usually in trees or right along a trail, like a deer trail or something like that, someplace where I've been walking. Not the big trails out there, but like these little trails out in the middle of nowhere. Anyways, I recorded this stuff. It looks like where I think the way it was left. And I don't know, I might put a piece of that footage in here. You know, it's from the other time because there's a big chunk of dirt on the lens that I didn't realize was there.
is actually over here, filming where the shelter is going to be, or kind of where it is. This is the beginning of the new shelter. Doesn't look like much. Maybe I should do some work on this while we're here. Actually, I think I will. So hang on. I'll grab some branches and drag them over here. Well, it's been about half an hour. Half an hour. I don't have much to show for my time here. But you know what? I've said before, it's really weird. When you start trying to find enough branches and stuff in a forest, especially see all these dead trees and stuff, quite often, there's not much to really find. So it takes a long time to find all these branches and stuff. This is mostly from the other structure, the other shelter we had from last year. I'm robbing all the pieces from it and carrying them all the way over here. I'll put a couple more pieces in the top here. Well, in here, just to kind of fill this space up. Mostly we're concerned with down here. So coyotes or whatever just can't come running through there and get to us on the inside. This is going to be a little bit different type of shelter. It's going to be a pretty small thing. And I'm standing where the doorway is going to be. We need some more branches over here. A whole bunch over there. And I haven't even started this side. This will be big enough for two people, I think. With the stove probably in the middle of one of these walls. I'm not sure. Probably over here. And we'll be good to go. I got a special tarp, I'll call it, polypropylene bag. It's a great big thing. And it's going to sit in here like a bag. And it'll be flat-bottomed, goes up the sides. And we're going to, I don't know, zip tie it or tie it somehow to the wood that's here. And put another one over top of this. Be another, there can be a roof on top of this. That's not even started yet. I'm not sure how we're going to do the roof just yet. I have an idea, but whether it works out the way I'm thinking or not will be kind of up in the air. So yeah, so now I gotta fill this one in, this side. Yeah, it's really weird. Is there once in a while I think I hear something moving around? I just keep ignoring it. But sometimes it sounds a little too close. I don't see anything, or as far as I can see. Anyway, let's continue here another bit. Give it another 20 minutes to see what I can finish. I'm still hearing something out there. I don't know what it is. It could be squirrels. I don't know. You know, I don't see any squirrels. Haven't really heard any squirrels. Could be anything. I hear something out there every once in a while. I don't know. It's just getting a little bit uncomfortable. I say that a lot when I'm out here, but it's true. Every once in a while, I just get the idea that it's time to go. I wouldn't say that just right now, but I hear something out there. It could be a rabbit. I don't know. It could be squirrels. I don't hear anything. I don't hear any squirrels or birds or anything. But anyway, I think I've done enough for now. There's that side. There's this side. What you're looking at is just the bare bones skeleton here. This would be a nice little area when it's all done. It's kind of short, small, but easy to keep warm. This is going to be the longest wall right here to do. I could probably do it today, but I think I've done enough. And like I said, it's time to go. So without further ado, stuff. Check this out today. There's a brand spanking new tree snap. Broken off tree. Let's go down here and take a look at that. That could very well be the second gunshot-like sound you hear in my video I just posted. You can't get over some of these odd, you know, these oddities in the forest. Not me, the trees. These weird structure-like branch placements and stuff. Here's some of the tree that's come down. This is what it's turned into. It's a bunch of broken up stuff. Although I find these pieces roughly this long kind of interesting. I find this a lot. I'll find chunks of tree that are busted off into pieces about, you know, is that 20 inches long? 24 inches long? There's a bunch of them here. It's brand new. It's oak. There's the piece right there that's busted off. There's a tree that's bent over. It came down. There's where it broke off, way up there. And here's where the end of the branch actually hit the ground. Yep, stuck into the ground about a foot. There it is. Looks like foot impressions down there in the leaves. Lots of stuff there. Lots of possibilities. You know, I can't see climbing a way up in a tree like that to break it off, but that kind of thing does seem to have happened here in places. It's the only way I can explain some of these tree snaps I find. Especially when this occurred on a day when there was no wind. This definitely wasn't here yesterday. So when I come to look at this, I consider a lot of the other stuff I find in this exact same area. And I tend to think that that may very well be the other kapow you hear in the video.